worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. To be prayed, I lift my head.
I praise you, Lord.
I bow my head.
I honor you, Lord.
I lift my head.
I praise you, Lord.
I bow my head. Oh, yes, I do. Oh, yes, I do. I lift my head.
I praise you, Lord.
I bow my head down.
I honor you, Lord.
I lift my
head.
I praise you, Lord. I bow my head. Oh, yeah.
You're worthy to be praised.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You're worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Help me to worship it. Help me to worship it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You're worthy to be praised. Church, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour, I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee. Hallelujah. I need thee every hour more grace. I need thee, oh. to thee. I need thee every stay. Time I need.
By your right side, but they would not come near us, Father God. So we lips. Father God, you said you would cover us, you would keep us from, hallelujah, from all hurt and harm and danger. Father God, so we are thankful, Lord. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. And all glory belongs to you. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bless me now, my Savior. Church said amen.
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 Amen. One for the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. It's so good. Amen. Amen to be in the house today.
Sure.
Amen. It's good to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And we ask that you get your Bibles and go to Colossians, the first chapter. We want to talk today from the subject. Amen. Through the blood of the cross. Through the blood of the cross. Amen. We want to thank Jesus for the cross.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Beginning at verse 19. Amen. It reads. Amen. For it please the Father that in him all the fullness should dwell, and by him to reconcile all things to himself, by him. Amen. That's boggling the mind right there, because they're trying to understand how all three persons could be in Jesus Christ at one time. Amen. Even at the cross. He said, whether things on earth or things in heaven, having made peace through the blood of his cross. And you who once were alienated and enemy in your mind by wicked works, yet now he has reconciled in the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and blameless and above reproach in his sight.
Yes.
If indeed you continue in the faith, grounded and steadfast, and are not moved away from the hope of the gospel which you heard, which was preached to every creature under heaven, of which I, Paul, became a minister. Father God, we thank you for the word. Father God, we pray that it fall on fertile ground, that they will open their mind and hear what you are saying to the churches on today. Father God, we ask you to strengthen me, Father God, as the oracle of Christ, to speak the word, Father God, that you have placed on my heart. Father God, we thank you right now, Heavenly Father God, for the blood that was shed on Calvary cross. Father God, that we have a right to the tree of life. Father God, we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Through the blood of the cross we talk about today. Amen. Through the blood of Jesus, we have peace. The Bible say with God. Amen. I believe I'll say that again. Through the blood of Jesus, we have peace with God.
Amen.
Salvation is free.
Yes, it is.
Amen. But it was not cheap.
Amen.
Man, salvation is a gift and costs me nothing. Amen.
Amen.
But it costs Jesus his life. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. I didn't have to pay for it. All I have to do is believe.
That's right.
Amen. In Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. It cost Jesus his life from the cross. He cried, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Being interpreted, he cried, my God, why have thou forsaken me? Amen. The Father would not look upon sin. Amen. So Jesus separated himself from the Father so that you and I don't have to be separated. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Romans 6:28 says, for the wages of sin is death.
Right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Death came when Adam sinned in the garden. It was separation from God. Amen. But the gift of God is eternal life.
Amen.
If you have accept Jesus, you have eternal union with him forever.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus paid. Amen. Our debt. The debt that we owe.
Amen.
This was made possible because of Jesus' death on the cross.
Right.
And verse 20 says, who reconciled all things to himself, by himself. Whether things on earth or things in heaven, heaven made peace through the blood of the cross. Through Jesus, we have peace with God. Man was at war with God. Amen. Fighting with God. Rebelling against God. Walking their own way. Their own path, doing whatever they wanted to do without God. Amen. Hallelujah. Galatians tells us 5:17, for the flesh lusts against the spirit. Y'all believe that today? And the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another, so that you do not do the things that you wish to do. Amen. Hallelujah. We are in a battle, fighting. Amen. In this life, a battle, fighting. Amen. Hallelujah. The flesh and the spirit. But Jesus drew the blood of the cross. Provided a righteous base for God's forgiveness. Forgiving us of our sins.
Amen.
Having made peace with God.
Amen.
Through the blood of the cross.
Amen.
Amen. Go with me to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians 5. Again at verse 18, it says, now all things are of God.
Amen.
Who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ. And has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself. and has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Amen. Last part of verse 20 says, Paul said, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. Amen. What God did for us, what he did for you. Amen. His blood at Calvary. He said, we implore you to reconcile yourself to God. Mm-hmm. Amen. Do not be at war with God. Yeah. Amen. Be reconciled unto God. Right. Amen. Can I get a witness? Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus made a way for us to come to God. Amen. So we implore you, amen, to be reconciled,
amen,
to God.
Amen.
Do not be at war with God. Be reconciled. We are new creatures, the Bible says.
Uh-huh.
2 Corinthians 5:17, old things have passed away. Behold, all things.
Oh, yes.
Amen. All things. Not some, but all.
Yeah.
And things have become new.
Yeah.
Amen. And whether things on earth or things in heaven, heaven made peace through the blood
right.
of the cross. Verse 21 says, and you who once were alienated and enemy in your mind by wicked works. Anybody know what he's talking about? Yet now he has reconciled you. He don't, amen, count your past or present sin.
Right.
Amen. He imputed it to Christ.
Uh-huh.
Are you with me, church? Amen. Amen. There are always some people who want to hold on to their old ways.
Mm-hmm.
They all want to hold on to their old way of living.
Yes.
But we are new creatures.
Amen.
Paul said to the Ephesians to put off the old man. Amen. Go with me to Ephesians 4 in your Bibles. And we see here at verse 17, he said to the Ephesians, this I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that you should no longer walk as the rest of the Gentiles walk. Amen. We should no longer walk like the world walk. Can I get a witness? And this is where they walk in the futility of their mind. Man, useless. Having their understanding darkened. Being alienated from the life of God. Why? Because of ignorance that is in them. Because of the blindness of their heart. Amen. I didn't say it, God said it. Amen. Hallelujah. You want to get mad at somebody, get mad at God. Amen. Romans 1 and 21 says, because although they knew God, they did not glorify him as God.
Amen.
Nor was thankful, but became futile in their mind, their thoughts, and their foolish heart was dark. And verse 26 says, for this reason, God gave them up to reprobate mind. Amen. Hallelujah. But one thing I like about God, he ran on the jets and the unjets.
That's right.
And another thing I like about God, he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him,
yes,
shall not perish.
That's right.
So I'm not worrying about those that are out in the world.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm going to take care of me.
Yeah.
Amen. And I'm going to hold on to God.
Yeah.
The song says, for the long we will understand better.
Yeah.
Why other prosper, living so we can day after day.
Yeah.
For the long we will. Hallelujah. Understand. Paul reminds the Colossians that reconciliation in their case was already a accomplished fact.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And I tell you that today. It's already been accomplished through Christ. They once were alienated from God, but now reconciled back to God through the death of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. To present you holy, blameless, and above reproach in his sight. Oh man, that's good. That's good stuff. Amen. Through my faith in Christ, I have been forgiven. My sins and my transgressions. Through the death of his flesh, when we stand before the Father, he presents you holy. Ain't that good?
Amen.
Amen. That's in your word too. Amen. He presents you holy. Amen. Blameless. Can I get a witness? Above reproach. Amen. I thank God. When God looked at me, amen, he presented me blameless. Huh? Above. Amen. Reproach in his sight. And that's through faith. I have been forgiven. All, not some, but all of my sin, through the death of his flesh.
Right.
When we stand before the Father, he presents you holy and blameless and above reproach in his sight.
Yes.
Amen. Isaiah said in 6:3, and one cried to another and said, holy, 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 hallelujah, is the Lord of hosts. Can I give a witness? The whole earth, amen, is full of his glory. Amen. The whole earth is full of his glory. God sees you as holy and pure. Amen. And righteous. Amen. That's a good thing. For the righteousness of Christ has been accounted or imputed, amen, unto you through your faith.
Right.
Amen. 2 Corinthians 5:21, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Amen.
Amen.
Not through my good works, lest any man should boast. Amen. Not through your commitment. Amen. It's not through your sacrifices, but through your faith. Amen. In God. Amen. I don't have no reason to boast. Amen. What I need to do is get down on my knees. And sometimes I need to stand and say, Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, for saving me. He didn't have to do it. But he did. Through your faith in God. God count us righteous. I might have not always. So how can the children bow? Amen. I come to tell you somebody is placing the guns in our community. But I see this morning that the guns have left our community. Amen. And went all the way to the mall. Amen. I tell you, God, amen, don't like what's going on in the world today. Amen. But I thank God I don't do the things I used to do. I've been washed, amen, in the blood of the Lamb. Amen. I've been sanctified, saved, and sanctified. Amen. In the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Do you know what I'm talking about today? Amen. And when God look at me now, amen, when God look at you now, amen, he sees me through his son, Jesus Christ. Amen. And through Jesus, he see me blameless. Amen. Above reproach. Amen. And his saint God see me. Amen. A perfect person through the blood of Jesus. Amen. Verse 23, and I'm through. It said, if indeed you continue in the faith, grounded and steadfast, and are not move away from the hope of the gospel. Amen. In other words, stay with God. Amen. Don't move away from the gospel. Which you heard, hallelujah, Paul said, which, amen, was preached to every creature under the heavens. Can I get a witness? Amen. In other words, be steadfast. Father God, be unmovable. Always abounding in the works of God. Can I get a witness? Amen. Live and he loved me. Amen. Died and he saved me. Buried, he carried my sin far away. Rise, he justified. And he freed me forever. One day. One day. Amen. 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 He's coming back, y'all. Yeah. Amen. He's coming back. Yeah. Amen. I thank God. Yeah. Amen. Through his blood. Yeah. Amen. Amen. I am saved. Yeah. Through the blood. Amen. Amen. Of Jesus Christ. Through the blood of his cross. Amen. Through the blood of the cross. Amen. It reaches to the highest mountain. Flows to the lowest valley. The blood that gives me strength from day to day.
That's right.
It will never.
Never lose it.
Can I get a witness? It will never lose its power. The blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary.
Yes,
the blood that give me strength from day. Today, it will never lose its power. Y'all believe that today?
Amen.
It soothes my doubts and calms my fears.
Yes, Lord.
And it washes all my tears.
Yes.
The blood, that give me
strength.
Hallelujah. Help me out. From day to day, it will never, it will never lose
its power.
Amen. Amen. It reaches. It reaches.
world if you need Christ in your life. All you got to do is believe on Jesus Christ. And the Bible says you will be saved. Amen. All you got to do is pray a simple prayer and say, Lord, I am a sinner. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
It reaches
amen. At this time, we want to pray for our prayer list today. Amen. Those that have asked for prayer, amen. We want to pray right now that God will. Amen. I want to pray a special prayer. And I want everybody to be thinking about Sister Watson, Pat Watson. Amen. She failed the other day. And I think she damaged her back a little bit, and she's going to the doctor. But she's in the pain seems to be getting worse. She texted me this morning again and said the pain is still there. Amen. She was hoping to say that it was gone. I told her we're praying, amen, that God remove the pain. Amen. So we want you to pray. Amen. And I also want to remember my nephew, Reverend McDaniel in Louisiana. Man, they brought him out of the induced coma, and he's speaking now. Amen. Thank God that he's on the mend. Amen. Because it just happened overnight last Sunday. He went, and then ended up in the hospital. The doctor said he got there in time. He had a cyst behind his vocal cord. His thing was getting ready to burst. God. Amen. That he found it in time. And we want to pray for Bobby Brown. Yes. Amen. Sister, when these crowds, Father. Amen. She called this week and said they called hospice in. And we want to pray for that family. Yes. Amen. And we want to pray for everybody. Man, that is on. We want to pray for ourselves, each one of us. Amen. And God, we speak. As I spoke this morning on prayer line, because people say they want to get back to what's normal. Amen. And we saying, what is normal? We're going to go back to it. And some people just don't believe. Amen. But when the children of Israel were getting killed by the snake poison, if y'all remember, the snakes was biting them because they were so disobedient. God said, snake in their camp, and it was biting them, and they was dying of poison.
Yes.
Amen. Can everybody believe? Just like the people don't want to get their shots today, they don't believe.
Amen.
Amen. God had Moses to, amen, to make a snake out of bronze and shape it, amen, and put it on a stick, and he said, set it out there in the camp, and he said, anyone who look at the snake will live. And those that didn't believe didn't look at the snake. Because God's ways are not our ways. It's silly to say, now you look at the snake, you're going to live. The ones who didn't look died. Amen. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. God's ways are not our ways. Amen. He's making a move in our country today. Around the world. Amen. Amen. And we must believe. Come to Christ. Amen. Can I get a witness? As we touch and agree upon, amen, our prayer list on today. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to ask Sister Freeland this morning to give us our prayer this morning. Sister Freeland. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Come over here and get one of these mics, sister. Amen. And we want to pray for everybody, every essential worker. Amen. We want to pray for everybody around the world today. Those that are in fear because of this this virus, those, Father God, who are not, those who are sick, as I said, God lay on all of us. Amen. Just in the earth. And I just want to thank God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Let us touch and agree together. Amen. As we pray this morning. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. It flows to the Lord's valley. To the Lord's valley. Yeah, 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 yeah. The blood.
The blood that gives me strength from Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. Lord God, if I withdraw myself from thee, we have nowhere else to go. Eternal Heavenly Father God, it's once more and again we come before thee in the most humblest manner we know how. Lord God, we are grateful and thankful, first of all, for what you've already done for us. You've already done some healing. You've already done heal sickness and health, oh Heavenly Father God. And we are grateful and thankful for that. Lord, you also given us time to go on vacations and come back. You kept us safe. Lord, you bless us in highways, byways, airways, and footways, oh Heavenly Father God. And we are grateful and we are thankful. Amen. Lord, but most of all, it's just a few of us. We come together to let you know, Lord God, that we trust in you. Lord, and everything is going to be all right. Lord, we ask you, oh Heavenly Father God, to touch every sick person everywhere. Lord God, you are able to do what you said you were going to do. Lord, your character is changeless. You are God and you change not. Your love is endless, oh Heavenly Father God. Lord, you left us an example to show us how to love. Lord God, continue to strengthen and direct us, oh Heavenly Father, each and every day. Lord God, touch the unsaved, Lord God. Lord, you see and you know what goes on. Your arms are not too short that you can't reach and save, oh Heavenly Father God. You're still in the saving business. Neither are your eyes so dim you can't see what's going on. Lord God, you give us a chance every day. New grace, new mercy, oh Heavenly Father God. And we thank you for it right now because you didn't have to do it, but God, we are glad that you did. Lord God, continue to strengthen, bless us and direct us along this way, Heavenly Father God, because we need you. If it's ever a time we need you, Lord God, we sure do need you right now. We just ask you to touch, Lord God, please, right now. Lord, we got families going astray, oh Heavenly Father God, shooting every day. Lord God, we just got disobedient people, Lord God. We got to do what you said do. If my people who are called by my name, we got to humble ourselves, pray, seek your face, turn from our wicked ways. Not turn around in a circle, but we've got to turn from our wicked ways and don't do wickedness no more. Then we'll hear from heaven. Then you will heal our land. But we got to do some change in ourselves. We got to strengthen our faith, oh Heavenly Father. You give us faith, but we got to use what we got and stop begging for more faith. And we ain't working in what we already got. Lord God, continue to strengthen, direct, and protect us. These and all other blessings we ask in your mighty and precious name. Amen.
God is good. Man, truly God is good. One that makes the know.
Right.
Amen. We are so thankful today to remember what Christ did for us. Yeah. Amen. He was getting ready to go to the cross.
Yeah.
When he had the Last Supper. Amen. Hallelujah. He instituted. Amen. The Lord's Supper, telling us, amen, to do it until he returns. We are so thankful to be able to be obedient to the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. And we've been doing this over 2,000 years. Mm-hmm. Amen. Hallelujah. Ain't God good?
Amen.
Amen. He's good and he's good all the time.
Yes,
amen. As we pray over the table that represents the body of Christ. Amen. We want y'all to put your mind on Christ. Amen. Think about what we're doing. Think about what you're doing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Discern the Lord's body.
Amen.
Amen. Father God, we thank you once again. Father God, as we stand around the communion table, Father God, asking your blessings, Father God, upon the bread, Father God, that represents your broken body.
Yes.
Father God, that whipped you to say it all night long, Father God. Pulling flesh from your body, Father God. And you did it for each and every one, Father God, that whosoever believes shall not perish but have everlasting life, Father God. And we think that everlasting life starts the minute that we believe in what you did, Father God. And we thank you for your broken body. We thank you for the blood, Father God, that you shed, Father God. We ask you to bless this wine, Father God, that represents your blood.
Yes.
Father God, we pray, Father God, for each and every person that's going to partake today, Father God, of your body, Father God, that this bread and wine that represent your body, we pray for them, Father God, that Father God, they will not drink it and eat it unworthily.
Yes.
Father God, we pray, Heavenly Father God, any sin that we commit, Father God, we ask you now, Father God, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Yes.
Father God, bless us, Father God, right now.
Yes.
Father God, we counted it done, Father God, that we, Father God, are forgiven in the blood, through the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Father God, we thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. For this time. Amen. As we commemorate and remember, the Bible say that on that night, amen, said Jesus took the bread, he broke the bread, and he blessed it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, this bread represents my body.
Amen.
Amen. It's symbolic, y'all.
Yeah.
Amen. Some of them, amen, when God talked about eating the flesh and drinking the blood, they say over 600 ran. Disciples turned and walked away because they didn't understand.
Amen.
Amen. How can one eat his flesh? But they didn't understand what he was saying.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Jesus said, amen, this is my body broken for you. Eat it. Amen. And then he said, the blood, amen, that I shed, amen, the blood that I shed represented, the wine represents the blood. Amen. Amen. Everybody been served? Amen. This bread represents the body of Christ. Amen. Let's eat all of it. And the wine. Amen. Represent the blood that he shed at Calvary Cross.